Hello guys, as you can see, I love tea and I love music. I love recording, mixing, mastering, doing everything with music. So I love to share my passion about music with you on my YouTube channel. The topic of today's video is my favorite and my only near-field monitors, Adam T7Vs. So I'd like to share with you my experience with these monitors. They are great near-fields. They have 7-inch woofers, so they produce sounds from 39 Hz all the way up to 25,000 Hz. These monitors have the same kind of tweeter like in the higher-end models like the A7Xs. So the ribbon tweeters. The ribbon tweeter is a cool technology that Adam uses in their monitors to give their products a much wider frequency response. Now I want to talk about the sound that comes out of these monitors. First of all, I want to mention that the mids, the mid frequencies are really fantastic. They're flat and they're rich at the same time. So you don't have ear fatigue if you listen for long periods of time with these monitors, like if you have HS7s or HS8s, which are really, really shrill on the high mid section. They are very accurate in the mids. That's why I love these monitors very much. So the second thing, of course, is the high frequencies. High end on these monitors is really smooth, it's crisp. You hear all the detail, you don't lose any information in the high end whatsoever. Talking about low frequencies and low mid frequencies, I must admit that these monitors do pretty good job, but not as good as I thought it would be. So low mids are a bit muddy, not as clear as high mids or the mid mids. The low frequencies are good. They have an attack, but they don't have as much bottom as you wanted it to be. So it's good if you have a sub. Actually, Adam makes a sub for this T-series. It's good if you have some good headphones that you can monitor on. But for the sub-low frequencies, I would not recommend these monitors. Great thing about these monitors is that they have high SPL level, really high. You can crank them up and annoy your neighbors if you want to, but you don't have to, but you can. I want to mention that these monitors are great for mid-sized rooms. If you have a small room, I think it would be not as good as a 5-inch. Adam has T5Vs that have 5-inch speakers. I think they're better for small rooms that because you will not fight the low frequencies. You'll not have lots of standing waves in the low frequency range. So, and you can take your headphones and monitor the low frequencies on them. One more really great thing about these monitors is that they look amazing. I enjoy looking at them. People who come here to record enjoy them too. They think actually that they cost a lot more than they really cost. That's because of their design. They look classy and they look stylish. They have that matte black finish that I just I enjoy. Now I'd like to talk about the downsides of these monitors. All the controls are on the rear panel and the light. So you don't see if the monitors are on or off. The light is not as bright and you just don't see if they're on. All the controls of the levels and the phase inverter are on the rear panel. It's not the best option because you cannot really place them near walls. But if you have about half a meter of a space between them and the wall, you'll be alright. That's it for this video. Thanks guys for watching. I hope you enjoy. Please subscribe, hit the bell, and write the comments below about the topics you'd like to hear about. Have a great day. Bye.